Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video we will look into top 20 geography MCQs. So let's start the video. Let's start with question number 1. Question number 1, why ozone layer is important for the living organism? So among the following, the correct option will be option number A, that is it prevents entry of ultraviolet rays. So ozone layer is present in the stratosphere, and ozone layer work is to basically prevent the living organisms from the UV rays which comes from the sun, and those UV rays can cause various skin problem and cancer as well. So this is why ozone layer is there in the stratosphere, to prevent it from the harmful rays of the sun. So A is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 2. Which continent of the world does not have a desert? So among the following, the correct option will be option number B, that is Europe. So Europe is the continent which does not have a desert. So B is the correct option, that is Europe. Now let's move to question number 3. Which one of the following regions is culturally closer to India but ethnically closer to China? So among the following, the correct option will be option number D, that is Southeast Asia. So if you look into the countries of Southeast Asia, like Laos, Cambodia, etc. So culturally they are closer to India, where they also have in Cambodia, if you'll see, there are also various temples, Hindu temples and deities are being worshipped in Indonesia as well. But ethnically they are more closer to China. So the correct option will be option number D, that is Southeast Asia. Now let's move to question number 4. Israel has common borders with? So among the following, the correct option will be option number A, that is Lebanon, Syria, Jordan and Egypt. So Israel has common borders with Lebanon, Syria, Jordan and Egypt. So A is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 5. Question number 5, which of the following best defines the climate of the equatorial region? So in equator, basically there is a hot and humid climate because the temperature is also very much high over there, and also there is a rainfall on a daily basis. So because of this, the climate is hot and humid. So A is the correct option, that is hot and humid. And this is the reason usually we found tropical evergreen forest in the equatorial region. A is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 6. The green revolution is mostly linked with which of the following crop? So among the following, the correct option will be option number B, that is the green revolution is related to wheat. So green revolution was started in India in mid 70s and 80s and early 80s, and during this various other crops were also being promoted to cultivate, but the mostly benefited crop was the wheat. And in this case, in the green revolution, the use of high yield variety seeds were promoted, use of chemical fertilizers and controlled irrigation, and there was the mechanization of agriculture. So these steps were taken. So the correct option will be option number B, that is wheat. Now let's move to question number 7. The process of leaching is maximum in which type of soil? So leaching is a process where the soil loses its nutrient due to high rainfall or high irrigation, and this is known as the leaching, and it is more seen in, the correct option is option number C, that is laterite soil. So C is the correct option, that is laterite soil. Now let's move to question number 8. Golden rice is a rich source of, so golden rice is a rich source of, correct option is option D, that is vitamin A. So vitamin A, golden rice is rich in vitamin A, and basically golden rice is a genetically modified crop, and it produces beta carotene that converts it to the vitamin A. So D is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 9. The planetary winds that blow from the subtropical high pressure belts to the equator are known as, So the wind that blows from the subtropical high pressure belt to the equator, those winds are known as, correct option is option number D, that is, those winds are known as trade winds. So D is the correct option, that is trade winds. So trade winds are the winds that blows from the subtropical high pressure belt, which is also known as horse latitude, towards the low pressure, that is ITCZ. So D is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 10. Which one of the following is the longest mountain range? So among the following, the correct option will be option number D, that is Andes. So Andes is the longest mountain range. So D is the correct option, that is Andes. Now let's move to question number 11. Salt trees are the typical species of, so these are the typical species of, the correct option will be option number B, that is tropical monsoon forest. So salt trees are the typical species of tropical monsoon forest. So basically these are a type of deciduous tree which sets their leaf, and then again at the time of monsoon, green leaves come out from these plants, and these are the type of tropical monsoon forest. So B is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 12. The largest tribal group in India is, so the correct option will be option number A, that is Bhils. So Bhils are the largest tribal group in India, which comprises at around 37% of the total scheduled caste population, and Gonds are the second largest tribal group, which comprises 26.2% of the total scheduled caste population. So Bhils is the largest tribal group in India. Now let's move to question number 13. Black Revolution is related to, so it is related to, correct option is option number D, that is crude oil production. So it is related to crude oil production, and it was an initiative which was started by Government of India to increase petroleum production by blending ethanol with gasoline to create biodiesel. So Black Revolution is related to, correct option is option D, that is crude oil production. Now let's move to question number 14. Which soil is commonly known as self-mulching soil? So among the following, the correct option will be option number C, that is black soil. So black soil has the capacity where they retain the water, and they have the capacity of self-mulching. So C is the correct option, that is black soil. And black soil are fit for cotton production as well. So C is the correct option, that is black soil. Now let's move to question number 15. Consider the following statements. Let's look into the statement first. Statement A. Monoculture means growing of single crop species in a field at a time. Statement B. It increases the productivity of the farmer. Statement C. This practice also protects crops from pests and disease attack. So which of the following statement above is correct, we have to find out. So first we will look into statement A. It's so basically monoculture means growing of single crop in a field at a time. So statement A is a correct statement. Also the farmer who practices monoculture, so the productivity increases. So statement B is also correct. When it comes to statement C, it is an incorrect statement, because there is a disadvantage of monoculture practice, where if there is any pest or disease attack, the entire crop may get finished. So this does not protect the crops from pest or disease attack, although this is the disadvantage. So C is an incorrect statement. So the correct option will be option number 1, that is both A and B. So A and B is the correct statement. Now let's move to question number 16. The earth without rotational movement would result into, so statement A, no sunrise and sunset. Statement B, no occurrence of day and night cycle. Statement C, only one season. So when the earth rotates on its axis, it is known as the rotational movement of the earth. So with the rotational movement of the earth, there are certain changes which happens in the earth, such as there is the sunrise and the sunset. Also, the day and night cycle also takes place. So if the earth stop moving or let's say stop rotating, so there will be no occurrence of sunrise and sunset, and there will be no occurrence of day and night cycle. But rotation does not affect the season of the which is there in the earth. It is affected by the revolution of the earth. So the correct option, so statement C is an incorrect statement. So the correct option will be option number 2, that is both A and B is the correct statement. So A and B is the correct statement, that is there will be no sunrise and sunset, and there will be no occurrence of day and night cycle. Now let's move to question number 17. Which one of the following is not an old folded mountain? So among the following, the correct option will be option number C, that is Andes Mountain. So Andes Mountain is not an old folded mountain. So the correct option is option number C, that is Andes Mountain. Now let's move to question number 18. How many hours of daylight does the equator experience on September equinox? So if we remember, in equinox, the sun directly is over the equator, and during this time there is an equal number of day and night, that is 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night. So the daylight which will be there at the equator on September equinox will be 12 hours. So the correct option will be option number D, that is 12 hours. So D is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 19. Air pressure is lowest in, so air pressure is lowest during the time of summer season. So the correct option will be option number C, that is summer season. So C is the correct option. Now let's move to the last question of this video, question number 20. Which one of the following is not a biotic resource? So biotic resource are those resources which we receive from the living organism, the resource which we receive from the living organism. So among the following, the correct option will be option number A, that is fresh water. So fresh water is not a biotic resource. So these are some of the geography MCQs which are relevant for your competitive exams, and such type of MCQs are asked in the government exams or any other competitive exams. So make sure that you subscribe the video, the YouTube channel for further such videos, and do share this video with your friends and family members. Thank you very much.